Hey guys, in this video we are going to turn this spreadsheet into a standalone HTML file. This HTML file contains different charts, like the sales and profit amount by subcategory. Additionally, the charts are also fully interactive. To create this dashboard, we are going to use the PyeCharts library. With that module, we can also create a navigation menu to switch between the different plots. And we can even create this sales calendar to plot the sales amount by day in a calendar heat map. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. Before jumping into the code, we need to get the Excel data into a pandas data frame. To do that, I will use the Excel add-in My Tool Belt. You will find the download link to this add-in in the description box. However, creating a pandas data frame or Jupyter Notebook is only available in the paid version, but you do not need this add-in to follow along with the tutorial. I will show you how to load the data without the add-in in just a moment. With that said, let me click the following button and select the data we want to transform. Optionally, I could also insert a title for the Jupyter Notebook. After hitting OK, the add-in has created a new Jupyter Notebook in the Workbooks directory. So let me open up a terminal and spin up a notebook. The tool belt has generated the code to read the Excel data correctly. But as I said, you could have typed the following lines yourself without installing the add-in. In the first cell, we will import path from pathlib to deal with the different file paths. And I will also import pandas as pd. If you do not have pandas installed yet, you can install it by running pip install pandas. When working with Excel files, pandas also relies on the optional dependency OpenPyXL. Therefore, make sure also to install that module by typing pip install OpenPyXL. Once we have loaded the dependencies, let us get the spreadsheet data by using pd.readExcel, followed by the file path, the sheet name, how many rows pandas should skip from the top, which column we want to use, and how many rows are included in our selection. With that in place, let me print out the first 5 rows of our data frame. Okay, this seems to be working. As the next step, we will install the module to create the dashboard. Therefore, open up your command prompt or terminal and type pip install PyeCharts. Once we've gotten that out of the way, I will also import some of the PyeCharts classes. So from PyeCharts, import options as opts, and from PyeCharts.charts, import bar, calendar, and tab. Usually, before manipulating any dataset, I want to get a quick info about the data frame by using the pandas info method. In this overview, we can detect if we have any null values in the data frame, as well as the data types for each column. For instance, pandas detected that values stored in the order dates column are indeed dates. Therefore, pandas has stored the date in a datetime object. We could now go ahead and manipulate this datetime object. Later in the video, I want to plot the sales and profit by month. However, currently the order date looks like this. Therefore, I will add a new column to our data frame using dt.month on the order date. As a result, pandas has inserted a new column with the actual number of the month. With that in place, we could now group our data by month. So I will call the new data frame group by month, which is equal to df group by followed by the month column. In our case, we want to sum up the values and I'm only interested in the sales and profit amount. Let me print out the first rows to see what our data frame looks like. Okay, now that we have the group data frame, let us make the data more accessible by plotting it. There are so many great Python libraries out there we could use. But as I said in the intro, we will use the PyeCharts library mainly because I like the interactivity of the charts and the fact that we can export the charts to a standalone HTML file. The only catch is that the syntax might look strange to you at first glance, and also it does not seamlessly integrate with pandas. In a nutshell, this module expects Python list as the input and not pandas data frames. Let me show you what I mean by this. In the first chart, we will plot the sales and profit amount by months. For this, I will be using a bar chart. To get started, I will initialize the bar chart object, which we also imported at the beginning of the tutorial. I can now take this empty bar chart object and add my axis. So on the x-axis, I want to display the months. As I said, the PyeCharts library does not work with pandas series or data frames, but that is not an issue. We could simply take the pandas series and convert it into a list. Next, let us add the sales to the y-axis. For the name, I will pick sales, and for the data itself, we will grab the rounded sales amount and convert it to a list. I will do the same for the profit. Optionally, we could also add a title and subtitle to the chart. Within the global options, you can find the title options, where you can specify the title and subtitle. And now we can take our bar chart object and render it within our notebook. Okay, and here it is, our bar chart with the sales and the profit. You can also toggle on or off the different data points. Additionally, right off the bat, you also get a fine animation effect when you change the y-axis. Another idea could be to look at the sales and profit by the different products instead of the months. So let us create an additional data frame and group the data by subcategory. This time I will set sIndex to false and sort the values by sales. As a result, we will get the following data frame. Pandas will sum up all numerical values. This doesn't make sense for the postal code or month, but that is okay. To plot the data, I will also use a bar chart. Let me shortly type out the entire code, as it is very similar to before. The only difference is that I use a subcategory for the x-axis and not the index. Additionally, I have used reversal axis to create a horizontal bar chart. If we render the plot, it will look like this. We can now see the profit and sales by subcategories. However, by default, the value labels are placed in the center, which is not very appealing. We can change this by accessing the series options and setting the label position to the right. With that change in place, let me re-render the chart. Okay, and I think this looks much better now. As we have sorted the values by sales, I can turn off the profit, and we can easily spot which subcategories contributed the most to the overall sales. Also, if I only look at the profit, we can see that some of the products are causing negative profits. Okay, and last but not least, I will show you a very cool chart to plot the sales amount for each day in a calendar heat map. To accomplish that, we will need to do some simple data preparation. First, I will group the sales by order date and round the result. After executing the cell, we will get the following data frame. Additionally, I will also reset the index to get two columns. One for the order date and the other one for the corresponding sales amount. As mentioned before, PyeCharts expects us to provide a list for the data input. In case of the sales calendar, we need a list of lists. So let me grab the values of both columns and convert them into a list. After running the cell, our data looks as follows. We've got a nested list where the first item is the date and the second item is the sales amount. To set the chart's boundaries, I will calculate the max and minimum sales amount we have generated in a single date. And with that preparation, we can now plot our chart. This time, we are going to use the calendar object. And then I will add the data and leave the name blank. For the calendar options, it is important to specify the year. In my case, the financial transactions are from 2021. Additionally, we could also set some global options. As seen before, we can add a title and subtitle. In this example, I will hide the legend by setting isShow under the legend options to false. And for the final touch, I will also add some of the visual map options, like the maximum and minimum boundaries, the orientation and the position. Okay, and now I can render the chart in our notebook. In the calendar, we can see how much sales we have generated for each day of the month. The color indicates the relative ratio to the overall sales. So the red color indicates a very high sales amount for that day. By looking at this, we can already spot that we have generated more sales in the second half of the year. Also, on some days, we have not generated any sales at all. Below the chart, we have a slicer to narrow down the result based on a specific sales range. And just to validate the numbers, let us pick an example. The 1st of January 2021 was on a Friday. According to the calendar, we have generated $1,482. 1 week later, on the 8th of January, it was $893. So let me scroll up a bit to cross-check this. And indeed, if we look at the dates, we can see that the amount matches. Now that we know that everything is working, you might want to share your insights with your manager or colleagues. Therefore, we are going to export our charts to HTML. But instead of creating three different files, so one file per chart, we will combine all the charts into a single file. To do this, we will use the tab object. I will initialize it with a page title. Then I will add our charts to this object. So we've got our first bar chart to plot the sales and profit by months, then the chart by subcategory, And last but not least, our sales calendar. As a final step, we can render our tab object. To do this, we just need to provide the output file path. In my case, I will save the chart in the current working directory and name it Sales and Profit Overview. After running the cell, we should have our new HTML file. The cool thing is that the file size is only 52 kilobytes, so you could easily attach the entire HTML file to an email. And if we open up the file, we can see our charts in the different tabs. Alright guys, and that is all for this tutorial. Let me know in the comments what you think about this library and if you want to see more tutorials on the PyE Charts module. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.